Aber das Wort habe ich
There was a
gedruckt.
doorway here, to where Dylan and I went, where the projector took us, where we met you. The arrow opened the same door here, but there's just an echo now. Are you close? Just on the other side?
Arriba. Mi è servito a niente. Che qualche slot in più si potrebbe dare, eh? No. Projektorról. Ah! Ne!
The projector's not here. Moved again. What did Darling do with it? I've got to find out.
Sono chiuso dentro. Bene. Ah, oh, che brutto segno.
Text on it. Color slide film. this side towards screen, and the number 36. The topography of Slidescape 36 bears deep wave marks. On the slide and in the distance, there's a formation of five pillars, like crude, outstretched fingers. There were casualties on our first expedition. Communication is an issue. There is no sound there, as if you've gone deaf. And radios don't work. Correction, a resonance from an unknown source, in part within the range of audible frequency. It acts in unpredictable ways, causing feedback loops that can tear you apart. Trench insists he heard something else. It made his ears bleed. Our equipment found no evidence of anything beyond the primary resonance. Trench's medical tests show nothing amiss. The projected image from each slide is a physical portal into another dimension. Only one slide remains. Dylan's sister burned the rest in ordinary before we could intercept. The text on it, color slide film, this side towards screen, and the number 36. The topography of Slidescape 36 bears deep wave marks. Expedition 3. We located the source of the resonance in Slidescape 36. It is an entity, a living organism of a considerable mass. I've named it Hedron based on its physical shape.
Hedron?
We've built a container for it.
You? Did he bring you here? Is that why you brought me here? You're here. You're here. They have you. I know you. I remember her from Ordinary. I thought I'd never see you again. Hang on, I'm coming.
Non mi sembra di vedere il secolo. Come... sembra un'idea di merda, posso dirtelo.
I'm Dr. Casper Darling, and this is my final message. It's not the end. But after this, I won't. I exposed myself to Hedron resonance fully. It is. It's changing me. I've been shown so much. Slidescape 36 was where Hedron stopped the spread of another. It's terrifying. It really is. It's another source of resonance. Trench was exposed to this other. It will now spread. I've done everything I can to stop the Hedron resonance amplifiers. I don't know if it'll make a difference. I won't be here when it happens. I should have told him anymore. I'm being sent one more lesson. Something wonderful, I think.
Here? You are coming through so strong. Darling used this HRA to lock the door. I have to rip it off to get in. Are you sure? Okay, I'll be there. Hang on. I made it.
The hole in your room is a hole in you. You can't. We let you into the hole in you! You have only been here. The only child. A copy of a copy of a copy!
No. Why did you. This was a mistake.
Oh.
Dove mi hai messo? Ah. Cazzo. Ma porca merda. vedo niente. Niente. Ah. Qualcosa.
Poster comes down and there's nothing there. It's just the cell and death. I was wrong. There was never anything there.
Hello? Polaris, are you there? Please. No, can't this happen. Please. Please. No. Please. Please. I just want to see you. No, I want to see
Happiness comes.
Uh-oh. Cosa? Cosa?
Federal Bureau of Control, how may I help you?
I need those field reports typed up and in management's hands first thing tomorrow.
The Bureau's the best at what it does, protecting everyday Americans from foreign threats.
There's the new girl, standing around daydreaming, and she should be getting work done. Who the hell does she think she is? The director?
Oddio.
Take care of it. nerve at this point. What is she?
Ah, ma questa è la parte dove non potevo venire. No.
Lost. Maybe you can find yourself in the director's office.
Grazie.
Oh, great. I was just waiting for my mail. Just leave it on the desk there, please. Please. Take the outgoing mail as well. Thank you.
What? What is happening? This? No, this isn't me. I'm not me. I can't. Why can't I feel you? Oh, I've forgotten something. I can't think. Oh, I'm lost. Oh, where are you? I can't feel anything. I don't want to be alone here. Am I? What is this? Why won't it end? Wake up, please. I want to go home.
You should keep trying. You are getting closer.
I need to go inside. I need to keep moving.
What do you want? Go away. Don't bother me.
Scusate.
Invaded. I must act. I have a plan. An answer. I'll take the slide projector to the nostalgia department. I'll turn it on. I'll bring the hiss in. I'll fix this. I can hear them plotting against me. We've been invaded, corrupted. I've lost Darling. He was the first to go. He's been exposed to Hedron's resonance. It controls him now. It controls everyone who wears the amplifier device. I ordered them not to use the damn things. They didn't listen. Hedron corrupted the Bureau. They'll never be people again. They're either dead or they're monsters. I'll stop them. I have a secret ally. The Nostalgia Department. I have my own slide for the projector. I took it. A memento. In ordinary. After the girl burned them. It's burnt, but it'll work. The hiss will save us all. I lost my train of thought. It's confused, like somebody, you know, switching channels too fast. I see so much, but It's too fast. On the expedition through the slide, something got into my ear, and it hurt at first. But then it didn't. It started as a distant whisper. Like something you hear in a dream. A faraway voice calling you to wake up. I'd open my eyes with those words still on my lips. See, in the dream, they had made perfect sense. But awake, they're like a foreign language. Already forgotten. Then the sense of loss hits. Like losing a child. Like losing yourself. You see, I was being taught a song. A poem. A prayer. That would light up my world and make me break through. Make all this pain worth it. Something once lost was found. And it made a home in me. A spring with, like, waves carving me and making me see. And it grew until it filled me. And I receded deeper into myself. Into this office. Locked in this oldest house, which is my aging body. I stared in awe through the peephole, and I was filled with knowledge and made better. You know, I often feel like I'm being watched. Yeah, like there's someone watching me. They can see me, but I can't see them. I remember it was like this dream I had last night. See, there was this man here in this very room. And then, well, sometimes he was a plumber unclogging the drain, and well, because there was a fish stuck there. Yeah, a big fish. But sometimes he was an old god, you see, and he had put the fish there in the first place to... To keep the waste. There was rising waste from leaking out. So he was, he was conflicted. But he knew many things. But he was also sort of senile, like me. It was like a riddle or an omen. It wasn't a very good one, or an interesting one, but I get so confused so easily. It's so very hard to follow everything that's happening.
I won't let them win. That's how it happened. The hiss got Trench first. He turned on the projector. He let them in. I have to remember the hiss. The hiss is the enemy. Burrowing in. I'm trapped in here. They're taking over. What am I doing? None of this is real. I'm not doing this anymore. Fuck this shit. This is nonsense. It stops now. I will fight this. I will find a way to push them out.
Welcome back. I knew I chose a good assistant.
I need my gun. I know what I must do. Start at the beginning. I should have seen it earlier. This is my mess to clean up. My fight. No one else's. I am the director.
Hello. This is Dr. Casper Darling. I have a classified message for the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. I have sad news. Hedren is gone now, but it was not a source. It was a catalyst. Do you understand? You must go to my office, the Endgame. It will be revealed.
I can't feel you. I can't. This is what Dylan wanted all along. But there is something. I can feel it, but I don't know what. The motel is a place of power, of change, a place to pass through, connecting everything. This is a dream inside my head. Why shouldn't it take me anywhere I want to go? Grow brighter around one constant. They revolve. Hedren is dead. You're alive, here, in me. Maybe Hedren put you in our heads when we met her. Maybe you were always there, and she was just trying to teach me how to trigger you. Maybe I'll never understand. Maybe I don't need to. Trench was the first to be corrupted by the hiss. Slowly, over the years. His need for control only made it worse. It was Trench who took the projector to the nostalgia department. He opened the door to the hiss. Just like that. With Hedren dead, the hiss tried to corrupt me too. But I'm stronger than them.
We're stronger. They're waiting. They'll try to stop us.
My sister had this dream, bad dream, and the whole world was dreaming with her.
Dylan?
She convinced herself that she was awake. She's all right, nothing. I had to end her dream. I had to wake her up. I had to rip down the poster she'd been staring at. Cut off her eyelids to make her see. To save her.
I know he's still there somewhere. Locked inside. I know, because that's how it was for me.
Dylan's in a coma. I don't know if there's anything of him left in there. If he'll ever find his way back. The portal's been closed, but the hiss is still in the oldest house. And the lockdown can't be lifted as long as any trace of it remains. I'm working on a solution with my management team, but there is still a long road ahead. I'm the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. We're in this together. You and I. Shawshank Redemption. That's the name of the movie I was thinking of earlier. Not important, but that was it. Paranatural power contained in one place is a risk. Makes me wonder what other dangers are locked away inside the Bureau.
There! Low-level security systems are up and running.
Every altered item on your list is now back in the Panopticon, safe and sound.
That's a load off my mind. Missing altered items don't exactly reflect well on me, you know. Did they give you any trouble?
The Flamingo pulled me into the astral plane just like the fridge did. That same creature was there.
I was looking over the old activity reports, and multiple items have been displaying much more destructive behavior in the past few weeks. There's some connection there, I bet, but that's a bit above my pay grade.
Well, something to keep an eye on.
And if I have any more runaways, I'll know just who to call.
I guess this is my life now. I'll see you later.
Like always.
Northmore sarcophagus container. The two previous directors both lost control while dealing with paranatural forces. I wonder if that would be.
Thank you. The director shut it down. No problem. It's a huge victory. Huge!
I heard she sacrificed her brother's soul to seal the histology.
What are you talking about? I told you 100 times to stop
the conspiracy. When do you think Marshall's coming back? It's not like her to be absent during a crisis.
I'll be here waiting for you when you wake up, brother. If you wake up. Even if it was a dream, I feel Darling reached out to me through the hotline. I have a feeling he and Trench won't be. Problem in the Foundation. Was Ati's vacation spot. We need to check this out.
Source of munitions and fed.
Director.
Darkness engulfed the elevator. There was something there, reaching for her, trying to make her act. It was a distress call. Faden sensed a drowning man, a hunger in the dark. Investigation sector.
Investigation sector, huh? We should check this out.
you, Director.
Hey, I found a file on the old director, Northmore. Didn't list any date of death. You know anything about that?
Could be an error. The record staff process a lot of data. Maybe it just slipped through.
Yeah, maybe.
I'll die.
An old squad made of Voracious.
Thank you.
Arrivo.
Thank you.
Dove stai? Porca troia, che spavento! Ma vaffanculo! Ah, ok. Madonna.
Saw it coming though. I should get these back to him.
Non mi lamenterò neanche per un secondo. Neanche.
Here are the pouches. I found six.
Well, that's all of them. Not counting mine. Well, I guess I'll just have to wear all of them. It sounds sappy, I know, but that's all I can think to do.
Nothing's easy with this. Is it rude to ask what's inside? What's inside the pouches? Too late now.
You know, the story's confidential, but, I guess I could tell you, being the director and all. So, the Bureau had heard rumors of a werewolf gathering upstate every full moon. Us being rookies, they sent us to confirm it was bullshit.
Hold on, is he about to tell me werewolves are real?
Turns out, there was an altered item that was creating violent gravitational anomalies during full moons. Oh, man, we nearly did it that night. Well, to remember the occasion, we all bought silver bullets to wear around our necks, just in case we ever ran into another.
So why did you leave the Rangers?
Thought I could do more good here. Somebody's got to protect the people who protect everybody else, right?
So, what's next for Simon Arish?
Well, first off, I'm banning all slide projectors. That's it. Seriously, though, we need to review our protocols. Research should not be making decisions that endanger the entire Bureau. Fuck it. The entire fucking world without some serious oversight.
I think Pope would agree. Certain people in the Bureau have been working in the shadows for too long.
And I'd like to make these HRAs part of the mandatory Bureau uniform. They're not stylish, but better safe than sorry.
I don't think anyone will complain. Not after this. What are your thoughts on me serving as director?
Well, I couldn't be more excited. I mean, look, don't get me wrong, Trench was fine, but... Well, you pulled us back from the brink, so... Well, I'm honored to serve, ma'am. I mean, fuck, shit. Faden. Sorry.
He'll get it one day. Did anyone ever mention to you that Darling was using the slide projector?
Well, Salvador never did, but, I doubt he even knew. Look, I'm well aware that it's our job to study and contain the things that we don't understand, but Some of the things that Darling did were way outside of our mission statement. Look, these things are not toys, and acting like they are is only ever going to end one way. At least Pope seems to understand that.
Well, it's secure now. No one can reach it without my say-so.
But thank Christ for that.
Marshall's been missing for a while now. Any ideas where she could be?
The last time I saw her was in maintenance when I was leading the Rangers out of the Atlas. Yeah, I told her it wasn't safe, but she said she had to go check on something.
Did you ask where she was going?
Whew, Marshall is not the kind of person you question. Kind of intimidating, you know? But, she was by herself. If that helps at all.
Not really, but thanks. Hopefully she turns up. I'll see you later. Jesse, good to see you. We've got Dylan situated in his containment cell like you asked. I've got medical staff running tests as we speak, and I'd be happy to walk you through the details later. Other than that, what's next? With the slide projector turned off, the hiss are shut out, but we're stuck with the ones already here. We can't lift the lockdown until they're all eradicated. If any hiss ever got out, that would be the end of everything. Eliminating them all will take time. Look, I'll do what I can on my end, but my research is progressing slower than I'd like. I think I can help with that. I am making you the head of research, effective immediately. I want you to use everything the Bureau has, every resource, every confidential scrap of data, and find a way to keep the hiss out for good. That's... really? I mean, yes, yes, I can certainly... Yes! Yes, I accept. You'll do great. Besides, I didn't really have anyone else lined up. I'm honored, Jesse, really. Thank you. Do you remember Mr. Tomasi, the head of communications? The hiss he was changed into showed up in containment, near the turntable. I'll take care of it.
That thing's not getting away this time.
I've heard reports about his particular use of language and intonation when repeating the hiss babbling. The biological and behavioral distinctions between different hiss-corrupted individuals is truly fascinating. I wonder if I could categorize the data.
And she's already off on her own thing.
When the hiss got into my head, I saw some weird things. I think Darling even spoke to me. Does that make any sense to you? Empirically, no, but phantom voices as well as hallucinatory states are not uncommon here. And considering the forces that Dr. Darling was working with, he could have been transferred to a different plane of consciousness, physically or otherwise.
And that doesn't upset you?
Oh, very. The fact that he hid those forces from me? It's infuriating. But Darling's dream was always to look beyond our reality. This time he may have taken a step too far, but as long as his consciousness can perceive his surroundings, I'm sure he's loving it.
Maybe Darling was just trying to protect you from the darker side of his work.
Fuck that. I'm not a child. Like, don't just assume I'm going to consider something morally repugnant.
Which it all was.
Which it all was, of course.
How do you feel about me taking over as director?
You act like it just happened. You've been director since we first met, remember? I'm still thrilled. Nothing's changed. Not for me. But the Bureau has changed. Trench and Darling are gone. Their knowledge, anything not written down, disappeared with them. They knew the Bureau better than anyone.
They're the Bureau's past, Emily. We won't operate like they did. We'll learn from their mistakes. We'll be better than they ever were.
We won't ever be like them.
Well, I've got a Bureau to run. See you soon.
Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.
Ah no, non so. Corridoio di transito. Bene, no? Dai. Ah no! Porco! Ah ma c'è... No! Che merda! Non ho capito un cazzo! Thank you. Porca puttana. Cosa invisibile lì dentro è veramente una cattiveria. Veramente una cattiveria. Di sciotta, cazzo. Troia! Che cazzo è successo di nuovo? Non ci credo. Avevo anche ucciso la bestia. Cosa mi è successo adesso? Cos'era? Affanculo. Madonna.
Listening to America Overnight, now in our 29th year, lifting the veil. I've been getting a lot of calls about this meteor. There were reports of a large spherical container that crash landed in a field outside town. From Colorado, and Sterling isn't far. I drove down myself to check it out with members of the America Overnight team. I don't need to tell you, it wasn't long before we found pieces of metal debris scattered in.
I took care of the Tomasi problem. Sorry, I forget he was a co-worker.
Don't apologize. That wasn't the real Tomasi. He died when the hiss got him.
You're right. I just didn't want to be insensitive.
Sentimentality is a weakness in situations like these, Jesse. That's Bureau 101.
I don't think Emily's in danger of being called sentimental.
So, there was a moment after Hedron died that I couldn't feel my powers. The hiss got into my head. Just for a moment.
So that explains the HRA outage. Before we knew what was happening, the hiss had us. They were in my head. I saw terrible things. I mean, I was about to go under forever when the hiss was pushed back. The HRAs had come back on. Dylan vanished afterwards, and we fought off the hiss that came after him. So if Hedron's death knocked out the HRAs, that means there must be a new local source for them to relay. Which I'm guessing must be...
me.
You. Hedron is dead. Assuming that word even applies to a resonant-based life form. But whatever it awakened in you, the power you call Polaris, is still active. Or at least, that's what my instruments are telling me.
I don't think we're ever gonna understand all of this. And I'm okay with that. I'm just glad you're here with me.
That's good to know. Thanks, Emily. I found Dylan attacking the astral plane and the board. What was he hoping to accomplish?
Huh. Since they arrived, Hiss have been corrupting objects of power, which have an inherent link to the astral plane. Maybe their goal was to access the astral plane and the board itself.
That still doesn't tell us why.
His motives are a difficult thing to work out, but I have been digging through confidential files and noticed a strange gap in knowledge regarding the board. Looks like any data on them has either been deleted or was never gathered in the first place.
Then maybe it's time someone looked into that.
Maybe it is.
How is Dylan?
The same. I can't detect any his activity, but his physiology has certainly been altered by it. And I can't tell if his brain activity is genuine or simply the aftermath of the hiss, like spasms. Dylan could wake up tomorrow for all I know. I really can't say.
Then I just have to wait for him. That's fair. He waited a long time for me.
Don't worry. We'll be monitoring him round the clock. If he wakes up, we'll be ready. I don't mean that in a hostile way, just... well, you know.
I hear you. My brother isn't exactly popular around here.
I hope one day he'll have the chance to change that.
Well, I've got a bureau to run. See you soon.
Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.
Acayip ya. Was it? Okay. Oh, yeah.